There are many steps to meeting smoke management objectives. Just to name a few, utilizing pre-burn modeling, acquiring spot weather forecasts, monitoring roadway visibility, utilizing air quality equipment, and conducting public outreach.
Use of the helicopter is a good tool that we can use to mitigate smoke impacts. The helicopter allowed us to get in and get this burn done within an hour, hour and a half of interior firing. Whereas if we had been doing it by hand, it may take us 4 hours. And that's just leading to more afternoon burning, more burning in the evening and at night, which increases our nighttime smoke issues.
The Forest Service has put a lot of energy and resources into developing technical tools. And the reason for that is that because if we can't meet our air quality objectives, sometimes a project simply won't get started.
For Forest Service burns here in the Southeast, high split's used in several contexts. One, in a forecast mode, our burn bosses will use high split ready to do a last minute check the morning of the burn, comparing it with their spot weather forecast of where the smoke is predicted to go. Takes the burn information that you feed it, location, ignition time, date, and then it goes out and grabs the latest weather files for that day. And that's important for their decision making that morning as to whether the burn should be implemented or not that day. An EBAM is an environmentally enclosed beta attenuation monitor that we use to measure concentrations of fine particulate matter when we're monitoring prescribed fire smoke or wildland fire smoke.
In special cases, a network of air monitoring equipment will be set up downwind of a prescribed burn to measure smoke impacts on the airshed. Air quality monitoring devices are not always required, but when they are, they're often available at Forest Service regional offices, the forests themselves, and districts. The Forest Service tracks the smoke from all prescribed fires and responds accordingly, as well as using basic smoke management practices to further reduce the impacts from prescribed burning operations. By using emission reduction techniques when possible, and coordinating burning with neighbors and regulatory agencies when needed,